Okay, we're going to take a look at doing some testing with a Fluke 88 meter. Actually, this meter is a V model, which is just slightly above the normal 88 meter. But first thing we need to do is make sure we have the meter leads in the correct jack positions for doing voltage testing. Okay, so we have the red jack in the volt scale. First thing we're going to do is check the voltage for the available power source we're going to be using in this particular video. The other one is connected, the black one, in the common jack, so that we have two leads that we can make in connection to parallel to the source voltage. Okay, so now we need to select the correct range on the meter for what we are testing. We are going to be testing DC voltage and the available power source that we do have. The very first one on the scale here is AC voltage that shows that sine wave for AC voltage. The next one above it is for DC voltage with the straight line with the hatch below it. So I'm going to rotate the meter to that position, and you can see on the scale here when we illuminate it that there is nothing on here as of yet. When we make the connection to the power source, then we will actually be able to read the value and we'll come back and take a look at that. So we have a power supply here. It's connected to AC voltage, and then it converts it to DC voltage that we're going to be using for power supply in this particular test. I'm not sure exactly how much is here, but we need to know the value if we're doing Ohm's law calculations when we start placing resistors into the breadboard. So very first thing I've done is I've clipped out the red onto the wire so we don't have any arcing or sparking or any potential for melting any wires. So all I'm going to do is I'm going to take my red lead, make the connection to the voltmeter lead, and then the black lead and make it to the black lead on the voltmeter. And then we're going to take a look at it on the voltmeter for the value that we have for the available power source. So you can see here now on the display that we have 14.42 volts coming from this power supply. So we need to take note of that's the available power source that we have in this particular circuit. So when we start doing calculations and looking at voltage drops in the circuit, the series circuit that we're going to look at, that it all is going to add up to the available voltage when we drop accordingly across each resistor. So taking a look at a project breadboard, and this is something that's typically used with electronics for laying out circuits and establishing how the circuit's going to function, for testing the circuit, testing different components, making different things function based on where you put them on this board. So there's different quadrants on these boards. Some go in this direction and some go in this direction. So anytime we look at the ones going across here, we're going to be in series. When we start putting loads from this quadrant to this quadrant, then we're actually going to be in parallel. So I've selected a couple different resistors. In other videos, there's an explanation on how we define the resistance value based on the color coding that's on the resistor. At this particular point, what we're going to do is go in and do a physical measurement of the values and then do the calculations for voltage drops across a series circuit. So all I'm going to do is I'm going to take these resistors apart and I'm going to start to lay them out in a series circuit in the board. I'm going to start in one quadrant and I'm going to jump to the next. And I'm going to take another resistor. And I have to be in the same row to make the connection. So I'm going to pick the next quadrant below it, and then I'm going to move and pick another spot in series. Now I have some other resistors, and again, I don't know the values, but I'm going to take those resistors. And again, I have to come back down and pick the same row so I have a same connection, a bus connection. Anytime we talk about a bus connection, it means that there are multiple places that connectors or conductors can be fastened to transfer power or ground. So I'm going to continue on placing these along, and we'll just start with three in series. And as you can see, the power would flow from this one, through this one, through that quadrant, through the next one, through the next quadrant, through the next one to the end of the circuit, which shows that we have a series of resistors connected together. So we're going to go in now and we're going to check the resistance of the series of resistors that we've placed in the breadboard. And now we have to make sure that our jacks are in the right position for doing the resistance check. So we have the black jack in the common, the red, and again on the meter it shows we can check voltage, ohms, diodes, and RPM. So we're in the appropriate position for testing. Now we need to take a look at the position of the dial to put it on the right scale for checking the resistance of the resistors that we put in the circuit. So now what we're going to do is we're going to turn the dial on the meter to the correct scale, and we want to be on the ohm scale. So we're just going to rotate it to that position, then we can go back to our breadboard and check the resistance value of each resistor that we've placed in that breadboard. So we're going to go ahead and make our connection now. And we're going to test the very first resistor. And we're going to look at the value of that particular resistor. So we're going to check the second one and read the value. We're going to check the third one and read the value. So now that we've measured all the individual resistance value, we're going to calculate out the resistance total in the circuit. And in a series circuit, the resistance total is based on the sum of all individual resistance values added together. So I'm going to calculate these out. 468 plus the 470 plus the 218 ohms calculates out to 1156 ohms. So now we're going to take a look at this and actually measure it in the series circuit. The overall circuit resistance should calculate out to 1156 ohms on the ohm meter. So at first we went and we measured each and every individual resistance value, and to get the overall circuit resistance we added them up. And the value I came up with was 1156 ohms. So now I'm going to make my connection over the entire circuit. And then I'm going to look at the value and see if it adds up to the calculated value of all individual resistance values. So now what I'm going to do, as measured earlier in this video, we had our available power source. So all I'm going to do is I'm going to make my connection at one end and make my connection at the other end. And as you can see, the power flows from the power supply unit through the first resistor, through the next resistor, through the next resistor, and back to the source voltage. So what we're going to take a look at now is, based upon the resistance value in the series circuit, we're going to drop a certain amount of voltage based upon the resistance in each particular component in this series path. So remembering that we are on the ohm scale, we do not want to cook the ohm meter by connecting it to a live circuit. So we need to make sure, prior to doing any testing on the live circuit, that we move off of the ohm scale and go back to the scale we are looking for, which is DC voltage. So one thing when you're working with breadboards and you have an AC to DC rectified power transformer to actually give us our power supply here, if the circuit takes some time to measure and calculate, it's always important to go back and check and recheck your source voltage, because based on the heat of operation of that transformer, it can actually change the output voltage slightly. So I'm going to double check what my source voltage is since we started at the beginning of this video. So I'll make my connection and check the value. So the value has changed slightly from what we started with. And now we're at 13.31 volts. It's actually changed since I did this measurement. So this power transformer is obviously changing consistently as we continue through. We have 13.31, 13.30, and it may even drop back down to 13.29. So I'm going to take the connection off, put it back on, just double check. And this one is showing now 13.30 volts. So now we're going to make the connection from the positive power, and we're going to go across the very first resistor and then read how much it drops based on the resistance in this particular resistor. So the voltage drop on the very first resistor, as per connection, is 5.38 volts. The next one that we've checked is 5.40 volts. And the last one that we've checked here works out to 2.51 volts. So what I'm going to do now is take the values of the voltage drops that I've already recorded, and I'm going to add them up. So 5.38 volts plus 5.40 volts plus 2.51 volts. The total on this should equal 13.29 volts, which means we've dropped in direct proportion to the resistance in this series circuit. So whatever we start with, we should end with as far as the voltage. So we started with 13.29 through measurement, and we calculated out to 13.29 in measurement. And again, you've seen on the display that it varies slightly and through explanation of the change of the voltage with the transformer. So one of the circuit characteristics of a series circuit is that the sum of all individual voltage drops will equal source voltage. So as through calculation and measurement, the voltage dropped in direct proportion to the resistance and actually equaled source voltage.